Hi there, how's it going? So today I thought I would do a video on the term snuffed it. And I got this idea from one of my viewers, Dwaine3893. He asked a question in my last video, he made a statement. He said, I just don't understand the term. He snuffed it. For example, haven't seen Dave for a while. Well, that's because he snuffed it last night. What does that mean? Well, I answered Dwaine and I said to him, well, it's probably referring to the extinguishing of a candle. Candles are very representative of life when you think about it. We use them at birthdays to celebrate each year of our life. They're used at weddings where the bride and groom take one candle each and then light a single candle to express their unity. They're used in many religious ceremonies. They're lit at the beginning of a service to signify the start, and they are extinguished at the end to indicate the service has come to its conclusion. So there's many things about a candle that is very representative of life. Now this term, more than likely, came from, you guessed it, I'm surmising it came from Great Britain because, and usually during the Victorian time, more than likely, because most of the others have. Now, back in the day when candles were used as a form of light in the old Victorian homes, they used to have a device called a snuffer, and it looks like this. Basically, a cup-type object at the end of a long stick, maybe brass or wood, and it was put over the top of the candle to extinguish it. It's also found in a lot of churches still to this day. It's a snuffer and lighter. One side has a wick on which is lit so they can reach high up and light those candles high on the altar, and it also has the snuffer on the other side so that they can reach up and extinguish those candles, tall candles that are above your head. So more than likely, this term came from the extinguishing of a candle. You know, when the candle goes out, that signifies the end of the life. It's lit at the beginning of the life. It's used through the milestones of that life. And when that life eventually comes to its end, the candle is extinguished. And certainly in a lot of memorial services and even funeral services, a candle is extinguished to represent the end of the existence or some service. So that's my guess where the word, the phrase, he snuffed it, came from. It was simply referring to the extinguishing of a candle flame. And it stands to reason, does it not? I mean, fire is an element that we need in our lives. The flame, it keeps us warm. It gives us light. And we use it to prepare food on. It's you know, to cook our food. It's an element that we very hard for us to live without. So that's my explanation of snuffing it. It refers to the extinguishing of the flame being the life within. I like it. Anyway, until the next video, and hopefully we're going to get out because if it wasn't so windy today, I would have gone and found a couple of little cemeteries I've been stalking. You know, I found out. Just take you. I got a number of cemeteries this year to take you to. So I'm looking forward to that this when the weather gets better. So until then, you know the rules, eh? Be respectful. Take only pictures, leave only footprints. Until the next time, this is Sharon saying bye-bye.